You know what I think it's time for? I think it's time to get started with SmartSuite. That's right. This is a video that comprehensively will break down everything that you need to know to get started in SmartSuite. So let's get started, shall we? So once you log into your SmartSuite account, first and foremost, you can see that I am in my workspace. In my workspace, on the bottom here, I have a various set of solutions. Now, a solution is basically a business project or process that I want to manage. And going inside of them is going to be the solution to managing that project or process. You can create any of these from scratch, or you can be like, hey, a solution from one of the over 200 amazing templates made by experts. And that's right, over 200 different options for you to go through and choose. All the different categories and workflows are highlighted over here. So you can click in this and see anything from church events to business strategy templates that can get your solution set up started right away. Let's start with something like marketing, for example. Let's pick agency accounts in marketing. After clicking use the template, something that a lot of people will like to do is change the solution color. So I'm gonna make it red, which is a favorite color of mine. And then also you can change the solution icon right here. So say I want to make it a person. I can type a person here, and then that would make the icon change at the top. Now you'll quickly see that there is a list of tabs here. These are different apps within a solution. Apps are essentially aggregations of different records, which is something we'll dive into more in a moment. But an app is a collection of fields with records inside it, and there is over 40 options for fields within SmartSuite. That's right, that's a lot of fields. You can see by clicking add new field here that if I scroll, it gets borderline excessive very quick with how many amazing fields that we have to offer at SmartSuite. So for example, if I wanted to add a new field in here, like a smart doc, and then press add field, I could then change the name to account notes and update this field. And this would be a place where now I could write notes about the accounts within my SmartSuite record. So inside of this specific app, you may be thinking, so can I just see this in this grid view that I have right here? No. By clicking on this grid view, you can see that this actually can take all of the different data from the app and view it in multiple different ways. So if I, for example, clicked on Kanban, I then could change the column to the size, then it would put all of the different records inside these boards, and I could drag these around and it would change based off of what the column was grouped with. So it would be size. I can do the same thing and change this to cards. So this just shows it in a different view, because essentially, like I said, an app is an aggregation of a bunch of records with specific fields. And then if I change to another app right here, you'll see that they're different field types. You can add new fields, create new records. I also can create a new app in the solution from scratch as well. Now, when working in any of these different views, whether it be calendar, Kanban, timeline, I mean, we got options here. We got a crazy amount of options. As you can see, there's map, chart, which is a great feature that not a lot of work management tools have. Just going back to grid for a moment, I want to highlight some of the ways that you can change what you see inside of the different views. You always have the option to adjust what fields to display. So for example, you can see that there's actually much more within here than I showed. So if I press description and drag this here, you can see that there's actually a spot for a description to be written. And then I can easily hide any of these as well by exiting them out. And then I can sort this data as well by different field types. So if I just want to keep it simple and just inverse the sort of, let's do size. I want to make it so it's largest first, right? Last to first. And you can pick any other fields. Then you can have secondary and third sorts as well. So say I want to do A to Z or Z to A for items that have the same size, and then continue and continue until you can't sort anymore. Now, when it comes to filtering, you are able to also filter out things, or you're also able to filter out different things with multiple layers of filtering. So where account name does, for example, where size is not, let's just get rid of the 11 through 50, boom, disappears. Or where account manager or is not empty. Cool. or where customer since is after. Let's do 1 year ago. Is before 1 year ago. We'll fix this. Cool. But that's a basic look at filters. Now, grouping is a really nice feature. So say, for example, I want to break it down into the different size of the companies. I could group it by size and sort it in either first to last or last to first. Add another subgroup within it for like account managers, for example. And I could also press collapse all in order to make it so that they open up one at a time like this. Up to my discretion, I can unclick collapse all and they are still collapsible one by one. And then I'm just gonna ungroup this by clicking the X. And a really cool feature that I'm a big fan of is the spotlight. So say, for example, you really like one specific thing. So I wanna highlight like about and forever. So let's do account name and do contains about and forever, or rather I could do equals with it is for about and forever. Check it out. You can change the spotlight color here. But yeah, it allows you to highlight whatever you want from the data, which is different than filtering, different than sorting. It's a nice little addition that SmartSuite has that's a great quality of life improvement over other products. And then also a similar thing, if I do find, I can be like RAM Jack. And rather than having an issue with finding something and needing to use like Control F, this will upgrade your experience of what you're looking for and finding it as well. You'll notice here, it even found the logo name from the PNG right there, rather than me needing to only do it based off of the account name. It does look at all fields. Now, you can't just look at this data from the outside in, right? You can't just be like, oh, look through this grid view. It's pretty. No, you're gonna have to dive into the records as well, because obviously we have different fields that could be hidden and we have different ways that we wanna look within this record as well. All of the fields will show up here. And you're able to change how the layout is by dragging these different things around. So for example, if I want to put the logo up here for some reason, I can put it up here. And I can even adjust whether it's like a list or a card view for specific fields. I can adjust and duplicate the fields, make something go over two columns because I want it to, remove that to one column, add a different field below within this, or even duplicate the field or insert it above or below. I mean, these are the kind of things that just make SmartSuite that much better than other products, because you know, you're usually able to just adjust the field, but you're able to almost play a game of Legos with this as well by dragging these around to your liking. So different and so much more advanced than other products for this specific use case. Now, another really cool thing is that you can even, for some of these, expand and focus on like just the logo field right here, or in the case of the smart docs, you can do the exact same thing. So you can focus on writing within this. Then for example, I can press Control Save and I would be able to keep working within this record. A really great feature within records is the communication center. Another great feature within SmartSuite is the communication center, which you can find right here. This is set up to be your communication center for not only comments like every other tool, but also go to settings right here. Boom. That's right. There's emails within this. By pressing emails, what you're able to do is communicate directly from this platform, have email templates, attached files, and even, I'm not making this up, add different fields, right? So say for example, within this, we can refer to people based off of the different field, like size. And if we had an email field, so say for example, I were to add email field, and for this two option here, then for this two right here, I can utilize this test email that I put in there and use this like a normal text editor to email internal, external, or whatever internal stakeholders that you're gonna need to get into communication with. Now, when it comes to the communication center from a comment standpoint, it's very similar to some other tools you've probably used. You can do at, and then you can add different people or different teams within a workspace. So I can obviously assign this to myself and say, communicate with the client ASAP, press send. And now I'm only gonna be able to see that this is assigned to me because I marked it that way. And I can mark this as resolved myself. And then once it's resolved, it'll disappear for now, but I can check this later by going to resolved. And not only that, but say it was reopened, you can see the assigned to me right here, and this is only going to show what is actually assigned to you. Another really cool capability inside of a record is that we can actually see the activity history. So it showed the fact that I updated an email field, left a comment, exactly what the comment was, the fact that I resolved the comment and which comment it was, and the same with it being reopened. Now, say for example, you don't want specific people to access this solution, or you want other specific people to access the solution. By going to the top here and pressing on permissions, you have a myriad of different options. So one of SmartSuite's best features is the fact that it just got an extra tier of quality in its solutions at a permission and otherwise level. So as you can see, currently it's set to all members have full access, but only having, for example, the content squad to have members of these two have access, or even from an advanced standpoint, what if I only want them to be able to be a contributor so they can't edit content? Or an assignee, they can view and edit content they've been assigned, but can't create, view, or edit anything else, as well as commenter, viewer, and editor in full access. I also would be able to specifically add members rather than just having it be based off teams, so I can make my other account a commenter. And then, you know, I'd be king over here as the owner of this solution. And at the bottom here, you can quickly add solution managers too. Now, I know that you just saw a comment, right? You saw how that was something that was interesting. What if I told you that you could add a trigger through automations within SmartSuite that are absolutely mind-boggling? So at the top here, you can just go to automations in any solution, and then that solution can have automations based off various different triggers and have a myriad of different actions following them. So for example, when a record matches a condition, so let's say for accounts where size is equal to 51 out of 100, we then could, for example, send a message in Slack saying, hey, for example, we could do updates to a sales pipeline and let everyone know that we got a big client on the horizon, all 51 to 100 people. So once again, pick updated sales pipeline, say account name was just added to the pipeline, and add any other field context you'd want. And then it would automatically send this message to Slack. Not only that, but you can also have a trigger go off when a record is created, when a record is updated, when a form is submitted, which is really cool, at a scheduled time, so on a recurring basis, and eventually coming soon when a webhook is received, as well as a really cool integration that's gonna lead to more eventually like when an email is received. This is the kind of third-party stuff that you just go, wow, this is in this tool. Okay. Because then there you can see there's obviously the option to create records. So for a recurring basis, you could see how that would be useful. Updating records, sending an email through the native email feature in SmartSuite, and then having a find records option, as well as using all of these different integrations. I mean, look at this. Upload a file. Am I worthy of this? Probably not. Is it in the app? Yes. Am I grateful for it all the time? Yeah. So whatever tedious task that you have, I would definitely recommend checking out SmartSuite's automations to make things just that little bit easier for you. And if you ever have any questions, you can always go to the bottom right and you'll find a myriad of different help solutions. And if you need even more personalized help, then you'll be able to send a message to the team and they'll get back to you as soon as they can. So you ready to get started with SmartSuite or what? I'm ready to hand this off to you because I think you're more ready than you even know. Just like you're more ready than you even know to check out this video on how to improve your productivity using SmartSuite even more.